Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Hello dear students, I am Dr. Mona Semalti from HNB Gadwal University, Srinagar, Gadwal. I welcome you all in this module. So, in continuation to our previous module on cosmetics and cosmeceuticals, today in this module, we are going to discuss about mouthwash, tooth powder and a little introduction I will give you about the whitening and bleaching agents which are used as a oral care product. Okay, so this is going to be our learning outcome, that after going through from this module you will be able to know about mouthwash, what are mouthwash, their types, property, tooth powder, what are the ingredients which are used in tooth powder. I will tell you about formulas of tooth powder and whitening and bleaching agent, the concept of whitening and bleaching agents and their types, okay, and their mechanism of action we will discuss. Okay, so this is your lesson plan. We will discuss first mouthwash definition, their types, properties, ingredients, tooth powder, that what tooth powder definition, their ingredients, what are ingredients, and bleaching and whitening agents. Okay, their types, materials which are used, and their mechanism of action. So mouthwash. So dear students, you might have heard of mouthwash, which is generally used to mask the bad odor. Okay, so bad breath also we can say. So that's why mouthwash or oral astringent solutions are prescribed. So mouthwash, they are also termed as mouth rinse, okay, oral rinse or mouth bath. So it is a liquid which is held in the mouth passively or swilled around the mouth by contraction of the perioral muscles and the movement of the head, and they may be gargled. So where the head is tilted back and the liquid bubble at the back of the mouth. So this is about mouthwash. Classification. So classification is cosmetic as well as therapeutically we can classify them. Cosmetically, basically they are they generally help to remove the oral debris before and after brushing. Okay. Temporarily, it suppresses the bad odor. Okay, diminishes the bacteria in the mouth and refresh the mouth with a pleasant taste. And this is commercially OTC product available over the counter. Okay, so mouthwash, if you ask to any chemist, you can easily get mouthwash. So next is therapeutic mouthwash. So it may be is also sold as a OTC product, and it to have the benefit of their cosmetic counterpart, and it has some medicated ingredients also like fluoride or chlorhexidine that help in the protection of the some oral diseases. So that's why we classify them in the therapeutic category, and they also of course they gives the a refreshing feel in the mouth, and they also diminish the bacterial in the mouth, and but they are also temporarily suppress the bad breath. Types of mouthwashes. See, containing antibacterial, containing fluoride and containing mineral. So as such, we cannot classify the type of mouthwashes. We generally classify them based on the ingredient, based on the main active ingredient they have. So antibacterial, okay, fluoride and containing mineral. So the amount of the different component in the mouthwashes varies from product to product. Okay, so some practically some they have the same composition as the as our toothpaste has, but they don't contain the abrasive, because in toothpaste what we discussed is the abrasives are the main ingredient. Why? Because abrasives are used to apply a little force for cleansing action. Okay, so in mouthwash it is just gargle mouthwash. Sometimes it is diluted with, so it is mentioned on the mouthwash label that what kind of dilution you have to make. So it is basically gargle. So there is no need of abrasive agent. So mouthwash is devoid of abrasive agent. Rest of the ingredients are same. So apart from toothpaste, mouthwashes, they contain alcohol as a preservative and as a semi-active ingredient, we can say. Alcohol, which is also used sometimes as a vehicle for, and it is used in the range from 10 to 20% concentration. Okay. Next is component of mouthwash. Antibacterial, okay, cetyl, peridinium chloride, that is 0.05% concentration it is used, chlorhexidine 0.12% concentration it is used, triclosan 0.03% concentration it is used, saline 0.9% concentration, and other antibacterial agents are also used like cinnamon oil, cassia, clove, eucalyptus, and peppermint, anise, menthol, thymol, methyl salicylates. Okay, so these are also used. Alcohol, so as I discussed in the previous slide, alcohol, which is present in 10 to 20% concentration, it enhances the flavor, provides the sharpness to the toothpaste. Okay, and it add a value in masking the bad odor. Okay, unpleasant taste of the active ingredient. So functions are as solubilizing agent and some flavoring agent, and it also acts as a preservative. Next is humectant. So dear students, just remember all these ingredients we also discussed in the toothpaste module, in the module where we discussed about toothpaste. So the same ingredients we are discussing here. Okay, humectant, and humectant, just recall the additives which are used in cosmetic preparation. There also we discussed about the humectant, glycerin and sorbitol, which is used the main humectant, and which is the very commonly used, and 5 to 20% concentration in mouthwashes it is used. And these agents basically they increase the viscosity of the preparation and enhance the sweetness of the product. Okay, surfactants, they add in solubilizing of flavor and the removal of the debris by providing the foaming action. Okay. Next is flavoring agent, coloring agent. Okay, flavoring agents, they are used to overcome the disagreeable taste. Coloring agent, they are also used in this product for providing the desirable color and distinguishing similar product in the eyes of customer. Okay, fluoride, pyrophosphate ion, triclosan and chlorhexidine. So these are used examples of fluorides. And sweetening agent, saccharine sodium, which is used, and preservative, sodium benzoate, parabens, these are used as a preservative. So dear students, it was about mouthwash. So although I have not discussed mouthwash in detail, okay, so mouthwash, just we consider them, it masks the bad odor, okay, and sometimes they have some therapeutic value to the product. So moving to the tooth powder. So tooth powder are one of the oldest, simplest and the cheapest dental preparations used for oral care. The market share of tooth powder has reduced from long time due to the popularity of toothpaste over tooth powder, but are still used by a huge percentage of population, toothpaste, okay, tooth powder. So tooth powder, it is an alternative to toothpaste, and there are some modern versions of tooth powders are also available which are without fluoride. Tooth powder, it was so if we go in history of tooth powder, then we find that historically it was used by Romans very first to clean and whiten the teeth, to fix them when they lose and strengthen the gum, and to cleanse the teeth basically. So they used to make the tooth powder from variety of substances such as bones, horns of certain animals. So the use of tooth powder substances such as charcoal, brick and the salts of cleansing teeth have been historically widespread in India. So this is the history of the tooth powder. But in modern times, baking soda has been the most commonly used tooth powder, although it has now been mostly supplanted by some commercial toothpaste. So you might have heard of Dant Manjan, Patanjali, Dant Kanti Manjan. Okay, so all this tooth powder, Colgate tooth powder, which is very popular, and we used to hear this since our from our grandparents, the Colgate tooth powder. So this is basically the same tooth powders we are talking about. Formulation. So what are the basic ingredients of tooth powder? The basic ingredients of the tooth powder are same except that the binder, because it is in the form of a simple powder form basically. There is no binding, so we don't use binders in, as well as humectant and any solvent is not required because it is in the form of a simple powder. Abrasive, of course, abrasive is very important ingredient in tooth powder. It is used in tooth powder and also named as toothpaste, like calcium carbonate, calcium phosphate, tricalcium phosphate, calcium sulfonates, and heavy grade calcium carbonate is used in tooth powders, whereas the lighter grade is used in toothpaste. Okay. So the formula of tooth powder is, as you can see in this formula, calcium carbonate, tricalcium phosphate, okay, sodium lauryl sulfate, sodium perborate, and secondary sodium, color and flavor. So you can see the quantities. So dear students, this formula I included in this slide because mouthwash in the earlier the topic which we used in this module was the mouthwash, but toothpaste we are discussing. These two topics, these are very small. Mouthwash, if it is asked in the examination short note on mouthwash, then you are just going to discuss the define the mouthwash, and you are going to discuss what all ingredients are used in the mouthwash and what are their functions. Similarly in the tooth powder, it is not a vast topic. Okay, so tooth powder, that's why you have to write the formula as a sample formula for tooth powder to strengthen your answer. Okay, so ingredients you have to mention, what are tooth powder and what ingredients are used. As we discussed, what ingredients are used, we don't use binder, humectant and any solvent. So abrasive is the main ingredient, and flavor of course is used in, and preservatives is all. So these are the ingredients. You can have a look on the second formula example. You can give calcium carbonate, dental soap powder, saccharine sodium and flavor. So just go through from these two formulas. Now, what is the procedure of preparation of tooth powder? General procedure for manufacture of tooth powder is like mix all the ingredient in ascending order of their weights in a ribbon type agitator or any other type of the suitable mixture. Finally, spray the flavor on the top of the powder and mix and stir well. So this is very simple procedure. So this is about tooth powder. Next is also very like this dental product which we are discussing is basically for whitening or for bleaching the teeth. So any procedure or any method a dental professional might prescribe you to whiten or to color and to brighten your teeth is basically teeth whitening and bleaching agents. Okay, so these are less popular because generally people accept their teeth as their in their natural way, and very rarely people go for bleaching and whitening procedure for their teeth. Okay, so what should be the properties of this bleaching agent? Basically, is it to apply to the teeth for maximum patient compliance? Patient compliance is important, and non-acidic should have neutral pH value and lighten the teeth successfully and efficiently. This is the basic function of this type of agents. Okay, and should remain in contact with the oral tissues for short period and should have an adjustable peroxide concentration. Be non-irritating, should be non-irritating, and should not hydrate the oral tissues or teeth, which is very important because bleaching and whitening doesn't mean to lose the hydration of oral cavity. Then there will be a lot of problems of dryness of mouth or some sort, as we also discussed this thing in our previous module where we discussed the different oral diseases, different diseases of oral cavity. So dryness of mouth was one of them, and we also discussed that it may be the side effect of any oral care product or any cosmetic preparation we take any. Okay, so if this type of bleaching and whitening agents which are used by the patient, so it may reduce the dryness. So it may result in the dryness of the mouth. It may reduce the hydration and environment of oral cavity. Okay, so should not cause any damage to the tissue. So these are few properties of whitening and bleaching agents. So types. Okay, so dear students, quickly we discuss about vital bleaching and non-vital bleaching. So vital bleaching, basically it is home use of 10%. Okay, carbamide peroxide in dental tray. So in office bleaching, about 30% of the carbamide peroxide which is used, and it is carried out in the single visit. Non-vital bleaching means inside and outside method using 10% of carbamide peroxide. Okay, so the material basically used in bleaching for bleaching of the teeth is hydrogen peroxide. Okay, carbamide peroxide, which is more stable than hydrogen peroxide, hence it is preferred over hydrogen peroxide, and urea, which stabilizes and buffer, which helps in the shelf life, and 10% of carbamide peroxide solution, which contains 10% of carbamide solution. Okay, so and tetrahydrate sodium perborate, okay, mixed with water. So these are the materials which are used for bleaching and whitening of teeth. So next is the mechanism of action. So little we will see the mechanism of action. When so this is whitening and bleaching is not an individual's it doesn't like the patient itself take this type of treatment. No, the treatment is it is provided and it is prescribed by the dentist. So when bleach is applied to the tooth, what happens basically, it passes from the incisal edge to the apex of the tooth through enamel, dentin, and pulp chamber within 5 to 15 minutes. Okay, so there what happens, hydrogen peroxide, it breaks down very rapidly to water in an oxygen ion and oxygen free radical. Okay, so then the oxygen molecule then attack the double carbon bond and break them down in the second carbon bond, so thus disfiguring out the internal colors. So the signal carbon bond reflect light and therefore make the teeth appear brighter and whiter. So the changed molecules are now translucent basically. So the molecules may also now diffuse through the pores more rapidly because of their reduced size. So dear students, it was about the bleaching and whitening agents. So just to give you a little idea about what bleaching and whitening agents are used, basically they are used to treat the discoloration of teeth. So these types of products are used on the prescription of the dentist or oral health care experts. So dear students, let us summarize this module. What all we have discussed in this module? We have discussed what? First thing, mouthwash. Okay. What are the ingredients used in mouthwash? Okay. And what is what should be the properties of mouthwash? What are ingredients? And then we discussed about tooth powder. Tooth powder, the ingredients which are used in the formation of tooth powder, what tooth powder is, and what is the method of preparation of tooth powder. Tooth powder, the ingredient basically used in the in oral care products are same as I told you in previous module of toothpaste also. The ingredients are same and there is a little change in the ingredient based on the nature and consistency and the type of preparation. And third thing which we discuss in this module is about teeth whitening. Teeth whitening agents. Okay. So, dear students, we have summarized this module. We have discussed tooth powder and mouthwash and teeth bleaching agent and whitening agent. So that's all for today, and stay tuned for more videos on cosmetics and cosmeceuticals, and thank you so much for watching this video.